He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at a problem regarding Graham's law of effusion. So the question asks us to consider the following equilibrium, and that is the one between diatomic chlorine, or a chlorine molecule, and two chlorine atoms, which would be two chlorine radicals. So this is the equilibrium between chlorine gas and the dissociated version, two chlorine radicals. And then the question asks, this equilibrium mixture is attained at 1200 degrees Celsius and determined by measuring the rate of effusion through a pinhole. So we're trying to figure out how much of each substance, how much of each species is there, simply by looking at the rate of effusion through a pinhole. At 1.80 millimeters mercury pressure, the mixture effuses 1.16 times as fast as krypton effuses under the same conditions. What fraction of the chlorine molecules have dissociated into atoms? So we should be able to figure something out, right? We know that whether we have diatomic chlorine or chlorine radicals, where that equilibrium lies is going to inform how many particles are in the system. The number of particles in the system is going to tell us something about the molar mass, the average molar mass of the particles in the system, which is going to inform how quickly this mixture effuses. So we know some things about krypton. We know about Graham's law of effusion. We know some things about equilibria, so it's a little bit tricky, but see if you can figure this one out. So the first thing we're going to do is start with the information we're given. We're told that the mixture effuses 1.16 times as fast as krypton effuses. So we're just going to use this ratio. We're going to call the rate at which krypton effuses is going to be 1, and then therefore 1.16 times that will be the rate of effusion of the mixture, or just 1.16. Now, in order to plug numbers into Graham's law of effusion, we also need molar masses. So the molar mass of krypton, we can get that from the periodic table, that's 84. But the molar mass of the mixture, we don't know, because that's going to be an average molar mass that's representative of where this equilibrium lies. We need to know what proportion of the chlorine molecules are dissociated into the radicals at any given time at this temperature. So we don't know the molar mass of the mixture, but we can solve for it because we have all the other data. So here's Graham's law of effusion, and we can plug things in. So let's put our rates of effusion in there. We have 1.16 over 1. And now let's go ahead and square both sides so we get rid of that square root. Now let's go ahead and plug in 84 for the molar mass of krypton, and now we can solve for the molar mass of the mixture. That's going to be 62.426. Now take note that the average mass of a chlorine atom is around 35.5, so the molar mass of Cl2 is 71, and the molar mass of a chlorine radical is 35.5, and so this is obviously in between because some of the species are Cl2 and some of the species are a chlorine radical. So we're going to take this information and we're going to do some more math now, this time regarding equilibria. So let's set up an ice box so that we can describe the equilibrium that is occurring in this system. Now, for chlorine, we're going to say that we're starting at an initial concentration of 1, and then change is going to be minus x, because some of the chlorine molecules are going to dissociate. So we're going to lose some of the chlorine molecules, and then the equilibrium value will be 1 minus x, be the 1 that we started with, minus x, whatever amount of chlorine molecules dissociated. Then for the chlorine radicals, we're going to start with 0, but then the change will be 2x, because for every 1 chlorine molecule that dissociates, we get 2 chlorine radicals. So 0 plus 2x means for the equilibrium value for chlorine radicals will be 2x. Now, that means that our totals will be 1 for initial, x for the change, and then for our equilibrium, we will have 1 plus x, because 1 minus x plus 2x equals 1 plus x. That represents the total number of particles in the system. And those particles might be chlorine molecules, and they might be chlorine radicals. But in total, there is 1 plus x particles. Now, it is the case that the molar mass of Cl2 over the molar mass of the mixture is going to be equal to this 1 plus x that we just calculated. So let's go ahead and plug in the numbers that we have. We know that Cl2 has a molar mass of 71, and the molar mass of the mixture is what we just calculated. That's our 62.426. That's going to be equal to 1 plus x. Now we solve for x, and we get 0.137. And that means that 13.7% of the chlorine molecules have dissociated to produce chlorine radicals, which is what gives us that reduced average molar mass that is lower than the molar mass of diatomic chlorine. So there's a little bit of practice regarding Graham's law of effusion as well as equilibria to look at this system.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.